The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th canto, 1st chapter, text number 9, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 7th of January, 1976, in Nellore, India.
दृष्टश्रुतभ्यां जस्पापं जानन्नपि आत्मनो अहितं करोति भूय विवश प्रायश्चित्तं अथो कथम्। महाराज परीक्षित सेड, वन मे नो दैट सिनफुल एक्टिविटी इज इंजूरियस फॉर हिम because he actually sees that a criminal is punished by the government and rebuked by the people in general, and because he hears from the scripture and learned scholars that one is thrown into hellish condition in the next life for committing sinful acts. Nevertheless, in spite of such knowledge, one is forced to commit sins again and again, even after performing acts of atonement. Therefore, what is the value of such atonement? Kachit nivartate bhadrat, kachit charati tatpuna, prayaschittam athupartha, manne kunyara saucava. Maharaj Parikshit said, sometimes one who is very alert so as not to commit sinful acts is victimized by sinful life again. I therefore consider this process of repeated sinning and atoning to be useless. It is like bathing of an elephant, for an elephant cleanses itself by taking a full bath, but then thrown dust over its head and body as soon as it returns to the land. In every religious system, there is a process of atonement. In Christian religion, there is a process of atonement called confession. Christian religion, there is a process of atonement called confession. The Parikshit Maharaj is practical politician. He says that he had also experienced that a criminal is punished and again he commits the criminal act. Nowadays we practically see also that government has enacted so many laws against criminality, but criminality is going on without any stopping. We have got practical experience, as we have explained last night, that in the airport the security checking is going on for everyone, which means that after so much education, every one of us, we are dishonest. This answer is there in the Shastra, Yashasri Bhakti Bhagavat Akinchana, Sarvai Gunai Tattra Samasate Sura. This means that if one is turned to be a pure devotee, then all the good qualities automatically become manifest in him. Harava Bhaktasya Kuto Mahadguna Manorathena Sato Dhavato Vai. Whereas a non-devotee, he has no good qualification because he is acting on the mental platform. As such, he will be always attracted by material things. In this connection, I shall recite one historical incident from the Puranas. There was a hunter in Prayag Prayag, you know, in Allahabad. So he was hunting in the forest indiscriminately. So Narad Muni was passing through the jungle and he was very compassionate to see the animals being half dead and half killed by the hunter. Narad Muni, being Vaishnava, he was very kind to all living entities. So he went to the hunter, whose name was Mrigari. So the Mrigari thought that this saintly person is coming to me for some deer skin. So he said, "Sir, don't disturb in my business. If you want deer skin, I shall give you. Please get out of my activities for the present." Narad Muni said that, "I have not come here to ask for deer skin. I simply ask you that if you want to kill the animals, you kill them total. Why you are killing half?" The hunter said, "What is the difference between killing whole and killing half?" Actually, he had no idea about papa and punna. Actually, those who are animal hunters, they cannot understand what is spiritual life, what is God, what is sinful life, what is pious life. There is a verse in the Srimad Bhagavatam quoted by Maharaj Parikshit: "Nidvitta tarsai rupagiyo mana bhavau sadha chotra munavirama ka uttama sloka gunanubhada virajyati vinapasugna." Unless one is animal hunter, he cannot be away from chanting this Hare Krishna mantra. So Narad Muni said that if you kill the animal totally, it is less sinful than you kill them half. Narad Muni said, "No, if you kill the animal half, it is more sinful than you kill them whole." The hunter said that, "From my childhood I have been taught like this by my father. I do not know which is sinful, which is pious." Narad Muni, as Vaishnava, advised him that, "You stop this hunting business and I will give you your livelihood."